Hi, my name is Rajiv Appana, and I'm a product lead on the Google Pay team. Today, I'm here to share all of the new features we've been working on since the last time you heard from us. This year, we're working on tools to improve transaction security across the payments ecosystem. We're doing that while also making things simpler and more rewarding for our users shopping online with Google Pay. Later on, I'll share the exciting work we've been doing to help merchants and developers, like the introduction of a new model for card ownership verification and a simpler integration process for our Google Pay APIs. Finally, I'll share how we're staying up to date with the strong customer authentication standards in the EU and provide a sneak peek into what users and developers can expect from Google's new comprehensive digital wallet. Now, all of the work ties back to our mission at Google Pay, which is to provide simple, safe, seamless payment experiences for everyone, everywhere. But before we start, let's talk about how Google Pay works. Our product works on a facilitated model. That means we securely transfer a user's payment credentials to the merchant. Merchants, in turn, pass them to the payment service providers for processing. Google does not process the payment and is not involved in moving the money from the customer to the merchant. As you already know, the COVID-19 pandemic has accelerated the shift towards online commerce, and with it came a large acceleration of online fraud. Statista estimated e-commerce losses from online payment fraud reached $20 billion globally in 2021. That's up over 14% compared to 2020. It's also one of the reasons we have made security our top priority and why I'm most excited to talk to you about our newest product, virtual cards. Today, we announced virtual cards. This is a multi-year project that has us working closely with the online payments ecosystem to make critical changes to the network infrastructure tokenization model. So what are virtual cards? You might be familiar with autofill on Chrome and Android. Autofill lets users quickly fill in forms on merchant websites using data they've already saved securely with Google. What's unique about virtual cards is that when they are enabled, we're able to replace the user's 16-digit card number with a distinct virtual number during form fill. This helps reduce fraud in the overall payments ecosystem while also increasing safety for our users when they shop online. With virtual cards, users no longer have to manually enter any of their card details at checkout, eliminating a big pain point. We do that by dynamically generating the 3-digit CVV to fill the checkout form without any user input. This is possible because whenever a virtual card is selected at checkout, the network or the issuer can perform their own risk-based authentication. For example, they can send a code to the user's phone if they deem the transaction might have a higher risk of fraudulent activity. Fortunately, we only expect this kind of step up to happen in a small minority of cases, so users won't have to reach for their wallet every time they shop online. For merchants, this means fewer abandoned carts, better conversion rates, and higher revenue. I'm delighted to announce that for users in the US, Visa-issued cards will be eligible for enrollment starting this summer. Capital One and American Express cards will also be eligible at the same time. Before the start of the holiday shopping season, MasterCard cardholders should also be able to take advantage of this feature. Virtual cards are launching on Chrome for Android and desktop, as well as across all of your Android apps, but they will soon expand to other surfaces as well. Getting started is easy. Users are prompted to enroll right after checking out with an eligible card. Finally, We're also making it easier for users to manage their virtual cards at pay.google.com. Here, users can enable the virtual card features for eligible cards, retrieve card details for their enrolled cards like the virtual number or CVC, or even see their most recent virtual card transaction. Now, you're probably wondering, what does all of this mean for developers? As long as your website is set up for autofill, virtual cards will work seamlessly without any additional change on your end. However, we do recommend optimizing your checkout form so that it works well with autofill on Chrome and Android. To improve the effectiveness of autofill and ensure a smooth user experience with virtual cards, make sure your form fields are tagged with the respective attributes for credit card fields as well as address fields. Next, let's talk about some of the other work we're doing to create more rewarding payment experiences for our users. Today, it's difficult to understand the unique benefits that each of your cards have when you check out. Yet, users often have a strong preference towards a specific form of payment. For example, many users want to choose a card that optimizes their travel rewards when they purchase a plane ticket. However, in most checkout forms where cards are saved, users can only identify their card by the last four digits and the name of their network. We're making it easier for users to recognize their preferred payment method at checkout. We're starting with showing users the card issuer logo and the name in the autofill experience on Chrome or Android. In the future, we will look to provide even more helpful information about the card benefits, such as points, cash back, and purchase protections, so our users can make the best choice when they are checking out. Moving on, I'm excited to dive deep into how we're improving security on the Google Pay API with our new model for card ownership verification. Today, customers can choose between using a tokenized or a non-tokenized card for their transactions. Non-tokenized cards, also known as FBANs, are the actual 16-digit account number on the physical card. When a card is tokenized, an alternate card number is created. This token represents the same account number, but simply has a different number than the physical card. Tokenized cards also have an additional layer of security in the form of a cryptogram that is generated and then passed to the merchant. Google stores both the tokenized and non-tokenized cards securely in our data bunker, where all data is encrypted before being shared with developers or their processors. Now, it's not a secret that there are millions of card details currently circulating on the dark web. So, we wondered, how could we make transactions even more secure for our users, especially as an increasing number of users transact online? To lower the fraud risk for merchants who use Google Pay, we're moving to a model where we enforce stricter card ownership verification upfront. The verification process breaks down the transaction into a few separate phases. Once our risk engine identifies the need to verify a form of payment, the verification decision service will determine the option that offers the least amount of friction for the user. Today, those options are inline tokenization and card OTP. Starting with inline tokenization, here's the UX flow of the current card verification process. When a customer tries to use a card, our risk engine first identifies if it needs verification before the card is used at a merchant. When prompted, the user will then confirm their card details and accept the terms and conditions. Finally, the user chooses one of their available ID and V methods to confirm their ownership. Here's the flow for the second option, card OTP. For reference, the card OTP method is often used as an alternate or a backup option. To verify card ownership, a small temporary authorization is made by Google that carries the OTP code. The user then logs into their bank account, retrieves their code, and shares it with Google to finalize the verification. the charge is reversed soon after. Once a card is successfully verified, the verification status is saved, so users can have a safer, more seamless experience across the wide variety of merchants that offer Google Pay. Next, I'm going to talk about how we're helping our partners in the EU adjust to the introduction of the strong customer authentication requirement, also called SCA. We have been talking to merchants and developers to understand how we can help them. The top questions we hear from developers collecting payments in Europe are, how do I implement SCA across multiple payment processors? How can I tweak the authentication parameters to minimize user friction? And well, most importantly, how do I ensure my conversion rates do not fall? To address these concerns, Google Pay leveraged device binding for Android devices. This allows users to bind their payment information to their device and verify their credentials with biometrics or a device PIN. This extra layer of identity confirmation helps meet the SCA two-factor authentication rules while leveraging Android OS features to optimize the user experience, allowing users to check out in as little as one click. This in turn helps improve conversion rates for merchants. Partners who rely on the Google Pay SCA solution report a positive impact on their checkout success. You can learn more about the Google Pay SCA solution at the following link. Now, let's talk about how we are evolving our APIs, tools, and documentation to support developers throughout the integration process. We often hear that our partners rely on multiple payment processors to comply with local regulations and provide familiar solutions to customers across the world. To make the integration with Google Pay APIs quicker and easier, we created a repository of open source samples for some of the most popular PSPs. These samples demonstrate the end-to-end integrations with each of the PSPs, significantly reducing integration efforts. They also demonstrate how you can easily integrate multiple PSPs with a single surface. Leveraging the same samples, we also made the integration easier for Firebase users. With the Google Pay Firebase extension, users can configure each of their PSPs all within the Firebase console. You can find out more on the link shown on the screen. In addition to the vanilla SDKs for Android and web, we have made other libraries available to help you integrate Google Pay using the stack of your choice. The Google Pay button component is the easiest way to integrate Google Pay into your website, whether your site is built with React, Angular, Vue, or many other popular networks. To find out more, visit the link shown here. If you're developing applications on multiple platforms with Flutter, take a look at the pay package in pub.dev to add payment functionality using pre-built widgets. You can check out the following link for more information. And finally, if you work with Android Studio, you can use the Google Pay template to access pre-built integration with Google Pay. Using the Google Pay Wallet console, you can take a look at the integration, update the payment configuration, get approved as a business, and finally, switch your integration status to go live on production. Google Pay has been on a multi-year journey, which started off as a convenient and safe way to pay in-store and online. Later on, our products grew to hold digital items that are stored in your physical wallet, including things like event tickets, boarding passes, and transit passes. Earlier today, we were thrilled to announce the Google Wallet. The Google Wallet allows any user with an Android device to replace their physical wallet while enabling developers to securely store and provide easy access to wallet objects across the Android and Chrome ecosystem. the Google Wallet will serve as a secure container alongside Google Pay. Users can save their payment cards to the Google Wallet and use them to pay easily and securely anywhere Google Pay and contactless payments are accepted. Google Wallet will be rolling out to millions of users across over 40 countries, and it will be supported on both Android and Wear OS. For more details, please check out the session Introducing Google Wallet and Developer API Features. Well, that is what's new across payments at Google. We're incredibly excited about the ecosystem we're building for our users and developers, and we look forward to bringing you more of our exciting innovation soon. Thank you.